At the outset, I extend a warm welcome to all of you to this valedictory function of the in-residence program for artists, writers, and innovation scholars. When the Honorable President of India assumed office as the 13th President of our Republic, he had laid down a vision for us that more and more people of this country should be able to visit Rashtrapati Bhavan and be associated with its activities. Amongst the various initiatives taken include the in-residence program, under which groups of scholars or teachers, writers or artists or innovators come and stay here for a week or two. A schedule comprising interaction with relevant institutions and other activities is drawn up for them. Ladies and gentlemen, the in-residence program fulfills the aim of drawing the citizens of India into the Rashtrapati Bhavan life. Yet, it is also an extension of the Honorable President's vision of promoting an innovation culture in the country. He has been urging people, especially the academic community in higher educational institutions, to promote creativity and innovation. He urged institutions to open innovation clubs to provide impetus to innovation activity. There are now about 86 innovation clubs in these institutions. Ladies and gentlemen, the 1 week Festival of Innovation is being held at Rashtrapati Bhavan every year since 2015. We are organizing this important festival with the National Innovation Foundation as a way to celebrate innovation in society. FOIN 2017 was held from 4th to 10th of this month. The roundtables were well attended by experts from inside as well as outside India. The Innovation Exposition was well appreciated for its range of exhibits from agriculture to engineering, animal husbandry to healthcare. The in-residence program started on 4th so that the innovation scholars had an overlap of 1 week with FOIN. This has helped them to interact with key stakeholders who are keen to take forward their innovations. Ladies and gentlemen, this in-residence program was attended by 14 artists, writers, and innovators. I express my gratitude to the Secretary, to the President, who has been very helpful and encouraged us at every step in implementing this program. It is only on account of her encouragement that we have been able to implement this in-residence program successfully. I also thank NIF, which has supported us on all fronts. We had earlier organized in-residence programs for 3 batches of innovation scholars, writers, and artists. Inspired teachers from central institutions, scholars from IITs, ISERS, and NITs, and school teachers from various states. On this day, these bright scholars will join a select group of in-resident scholars of RB. We look forward to have this engagement with them alive. With these few words, I once again welcome you all to this function. I thank all of you.
Good afternoon, everyone. Honorable President of India, Shri Pranab Mukherjee, Secretary to the President, Srimati Amita Paulji, Director N.K. Sudhanshuji, OSD, Srimati Anjali Bakshi Ma'am, Executive Vice Chairman of NIF, Professor Anil Gupta Ji, all the dignitaries on the dais and invitees. On the behalf of Writer and Artist in Residence program, I would like to share few memories of our stay in Rashtrapati Bhavan. During our stay, we got the opportunity to visit RBCC, Museum, Mughal Garden, Library, Sarodhay Vidyalaya, Ayush, also witnessed Nari Shakti Puraskar at Darbar Hall and various award functions. We also visited Parliament House, Lalit Kala Academy, Sahitya Academy, ICCR, Smart Gram Project, and private galleries, etc. Once again, I would like to thank all members of RB family for giving us the special hospitality and much needed support. Jai Hind. And one small memory I would like to give a behalf of a writer, artist. I'll give it a small painting to Amita Paulji ma'am. So please.
Srimati Amita Paul, Honorable Secretary to the President, OHT, Directors, Executive Vice Chairperson, NIO, वो उपस्थित सभी गणमान्य राइटर्स एंड इनोवेटर्स, आप सभी को मेरा प्रणाम। मैं अजय कुमार शर्मा, वाराणसी उत्तर प्रदेश से हूँ। मैं अपनी और सभी इनोवेटर्स की तरफ से कुछ कहने जा रहा हूँ। आज फेस्टिवल ऑफ इनोवेशन 2017 का समापन समारोह है। यह हमारे लिए सुखद घड़ी भी है और दुखद घड़ी भी। ये दिन राष्ट्रपति भवन में इतने अच्छे से गुजरे कि समय का पता नहीं चला। फाइन का जो उद्देश्य था बहुत ही अच्छे से रहा और फाइन ने ग्रास रूट इनोवेटर्स की स्पिरिट को बढ़ाया है। राष्ट्रपति भवन ने इनोवेटर्स को एक पारिवारिक और सकारात्मक वातावरण दिया। फाइन ने इनोवेशंस को मजबूती देने के उद्देश्य से विभिन्न तकनीकी विशेषज्ञों, संस्थाओं और मंत्रालयों से जोड़ा। एक इनोवेटर के मन में जितनी इच्छाएँ पाने की होती है, फाइन ने हमें सब कुछ दिया। नाम, इज्जत और फ्यूचर के लिए एक अच्छा प्लेटफॉर्म, संबंधित मंत्रालयों से जुड़ना हर इनोवेटर की ख्वाहिश होती है, जो कि फाइन ने पूरा कर दिया। इतना बड़ा आयोजन करना और सफल बनाना कोई मामूली बात नहीं है। इसका अंदाज़ा तो सिर्फ प्रेसिडेंट हाउस की टीम और NIF की टीम भली बात ही जानती है। समारोह हम राष्ट्रपति भवन में मना रहे हैं, पर उत्साह पूरे देश में मैंने देखा। ऐसा आयोजन पहले के वर्षों में कभी नहीं हुआ। आज उत्तर प्रदेश को मुझ पर नाज है कि मैं राष्ट्रपति भवन में फाइन का हिस्सा बना। तमिलनाडु को आकाश मनोज पर कि उसका कम उम्र का बेटा इतना बड़ा खोजपुरी मानव जाति को दिया। आज राजस्थान भी इतरा रहा है कि संतोष प्रचार और संत सुभाष होला उनके बेटे और बेटियां हैं। वहीं गुजरात गर्व से कह रहा है कि मनसुख प्रजापति और परेश पंचाल ग्रास रूट इनोवेटर्स मेरे बेटे मशहूर उद्योगपति बन गए। वहीं बिहार इस बात का जश्न मना रहा है कि उसकी बेटी शालिनी सबके बुढ़ापे का सहारा बन रही है, और कर्नाटका की खुशियां पूरे राज्य में हैं कि उसका बेटा गिरीश बंदरगोड़ औरों को जीवन देने का महान कार्य कर रहे हैं। कहते हैं ना कि जल ही जीवन है। पंजाब के खेतों में खुशियों की लहर दौड़ गई है कि अब कोई नया दोस्त उनके बीच आने वाला है। पंजाब सुरजीत सिंह जैसे बेटे पर इतरा रहा है, और नागालैंड को गुमान है कि उसका बेटा मुआ शुबांग दुनिया को एक और नए धुन पे नचाएगा। मुझे इतनी खुशी है कि बस शब्द नहीं मिल रहे हैं। सभी इनोवेटर्स यहाँ एक परिवार की तरह रहे, ऐसा किसी को नहीं लगा कि हम पहली बार मिले। आज समझ में आया क्यों कहते हैं और सुनते हैं कि सारे जहाँ से अच्छा हिंदुस्तान हमारा, हम बुलबुले हैं इसकी ये गुलशिता हमारा। सभी इनोवेटर्स का अनुभव यहाँ पर बहुत अच्छा रहा। सब फाइन का हिस्सा बनने पे बहुत प्रफुल्लित हैं। आगे भी हम सभी देश के लिए इनोवेशन करते रहेंगे, ऐसा सबका दृढ़ निश्चय है। हम दोबारा सेलेक्ट होकर आए यहाँ पर, ऐसा फिर सभी प्रयास करेंगे। और हम सभी को इस बात पर गर्व है कि श्री प्रणब मुखर्जी हमारे माननीय राष्ट्रपति हमारे देश के राष्ट्रपति हैं। उन्होंने इनोवेटर्स की क्रिएटिविटी को सम्मान दिया, हम सबका हौसला बढ़ाया। राष्ट्रपति जी का हम सभी इनोवेटर से मिलना, राष्ट्रपति भवन में आकर इस गरिमामयी वातावरण में रहना, इतना बड़ा इनिशिएटिव कोई सच्चा देशभक्त ही कर सकता है। हमने इन 16 दिनों में मिनी इंडिया देखा। यहाँ इतना शानदार एग्जीबिशन का आयोजन अपने आप में बहुत महान कार्य है। इससे पूरा देश आगे बढ़ेगा। हर कोई का चेहरा मुस्कुरा रहा था, और क्या चाहिए। हम इनोवेटर्स इतनी खुशियाँ इतनी दौलत यहाँ से लेकर जा रहे हैं कि पूरी ज़िंदगी कम नहीं पड़ेगी। ऐसे मौके पर मैं ज़रा भावुक हो जाता हूँ, कहीं मेरी आँखें नम हो गई तो मुझे क्षमा कीजिएगा। ऑनरेबल श्रीमती ओमिता पॉल, आपकी जितनी भी तारीफ की जाए कम है। आपने जिस तरह से इन योजनाओं को ज़मीनी स्तर पर लाई, ऐसा कम देखने को मिलता है। आने वाले समय में स्मार्ट ग्राम पूरे विश्व के लिए रोल मॉडल बनेगा, हमें आप पे गर्व है। श्री शकील आलम सर, आपने फुआइन को सफल बनाने में दिन रात एक कर दिया और हमेशा हम सबका ख्याल रखा। श्रीमती प्रेमदा मैम, आप निरंतर हमसे बातचीत करते रहीं, हमें यहाँ तक आने में मार्गदर्शन किया। श्री निरंजन कुमार सुधांशु सर, आपने आगे बढ़कर काम करने और स्मार्ट ग्राम पे कार्य करने पे मार्गदर्शन किया। हम श्री रोशन सिंह संवेदना मैम, उन सभी राष्ट्रपति भवन के कर्मचारियों का धन्यवाद देते हैं। सभी के नाम से हम परिचित नहीं हैं, हम पूरी इनोवेटर्स फैमिली की तरफ से उनका धन्यवाद देते हैं। एनआईएफ इंडिया आज किसी परिचय का मोहताज नहीं है। श्री प्रोफेसर अनिल कुमार गुप्ता सर का जितनी भी तारीफ की जाए वो कम है। आपने तो असंभव को संभव कर दिखाया। आप हमेशा हम जैसे छोटे मोटे इनोवेटर्स पे अपने आशीर्वाद बनाए रखिएगा, ऐसी कामना करते हैं। इन रेजिडेंस प्रोग्राम में पिता समान हम सबका ख्याल रखने वाले श्री महेश पटेल सर, आपने हमारे लिए बहुत कड़ी मेहनत की, संतान की तरह आपने हमारा ख्याल रखा। वहीं तुषार सर, बड़े भाई की तरह हर कदम पे हमारा मार्गदर्शन किए। आप सभी बहुत अच्छे हैं। राष्ट्रपति जी, ऑनरेबल सेक्रेटरी मैम, श्री शकील सर, राष्ट्रपति भवन की इंटायर टीम, NIF और श्री महेश पटेल सर, जाने अनजाने में हम सभी इनोवेटर से कोई गलती हो गई होगी तो उसे आप सभी क्षमा कर दीजिएगा। धन्यवाद। जय हिंद।
It's a very special occasion when President said to each one of you that you are very special. He meant every word of it. And he described, as you remember, that day when you met him on 15th, the energy that you bring to the Rashtrapati Bhavan and the dignity that you bring to your own work makes you very special. You are special, he said, because you solve problems. You are special because you express feelings of our society which otherwise remain unheard, unseen. This is a special occasion also because the presidency, Innovation Presidency 2012-2017, will be remembered in the history of our country for having raised the stature of grassroots innovations to a level unprecedented in the world. I have said it and I would like to repeat that there is probably no other country in the world where head of the state hosts innovators at his residence for 2 weeks besides artists and writers. This is a special privilege that our country has given to the artists and writers and to the innovators, grassroots innovators, also signifies a very major message that I think will go through you to every corner of the country, that this country cares. The cabinet ministers you met, each one of them has given very strong encouragement to your ideas. I understand that Power Minister took particular interest in raising the stature and raising the reach of your innovations and technologies to much farther level than NIF could ever achieve on its own. Honeybee Network paved the way for you to walk to Rashtrapati Bhavan, and I'm sure you will help many more innovators, many more artists, many more writers to come to this place. It is very important for us to remember that it is entirely the effort of civil society, the people who help us reach more than 560 districts. NIF, with its limited staff, couldn't have reached that many districts, that many parts of the country. Dr. Vipin and his team have done extraordinary effort, along with Shakil, Sudhanshu, and many other colleagues here. I would like to thank a few of them, Mr. Thomas Matthew, who organized a meeting preparatory to the Festival of Innovation. You may not have met him as often as you deserve to, but probably his hand was visible in everything that was done for all the logistics and all the arrangements that were made. Military and Deputy Military Secretary, who made the entire security arrangement so flexible and so convenient to you and your people who came to visit you during your stay here that you may not have realized it. Gayatri, Isar, Sidhanshu, our dear friend Shakil Alam, who hosted us with so many teas and snacks, because every time there was an issue, we could resolve it within no time, and we could bring the grace of the Rashtrapati Bhavan to everything that we tried to do together. All the staff members of Rashtrapati Bhavan have made it possible for us to be able to organize Festival of Innovation and this program in a manner that we could make it special for you to remember and to spread this feeling to far corners of the country. I would like to recall some of the contributions, some of the promises, some of the commitments that have been made by the Government of India to our innovation movement. Niti Aayog has expected us, has promised us that the time taken by the patent office to clear the grassroots innovation patents will be shortened, and they will make an effort that all the innovators get a fast track. We will try our best to do that. Secretary Northeast made it a particular point that there's so much need in Northeast of our country for innovations to diffuse, innovations to be recognized, and an effort is going to be made to connect them all. Commerce Minister, Mrs. Nirmala Sitharaman, also took interest in the fact that our innovators should not only be able to get their innovations reach in corners of India, but probably other parts of the world with various incentive schemes that exist. Akash has been assured all the help from ICMR, DBT and other institutions, so that while studying in Bangalore, his technology also continues to grow, and he becomes a role model for many more school children to be able to look at the problems of our life and try to find solution. What he noticed at the time of his grandfather suffering from the heart attack did not remain only as a personal problem. It has become now a solution which will affect large number of grandfathers and mothers and others in our society. The Cultural Ministry has promised to give wings to the ideas of our innovator from Nagaland. Our innovators, whether it is in bamboo, steam, biogas, plant varieties, all of them have been promised support by different wings of the government. The director of the Indian Rice Research Institute came all the way and promised Mr. Sujit that he will invite him again to Hyderabad and also try that his variety diffuses in as many different regions where this problem of salinity exists. So also the Indian Institute of Vegetable Research tried to provide support. In the director of INMAS is here, DRDO showed a lot of interest in how can they link up with the grassroots innovation so that frugal innovations reach our forces and the people who defend our borders also get the benefit of our innovations and the frugality and the affordability of our innovations. Bureau of Indian Standard has shown interest that they will try to see that the innovations don't suffer from replication and from wider reach because there are no appropriate standards for them. The Handicapped Finance Corporation took interest in the walker of Shalini because our team fabricated this walker, they realized that on our own we will not be able to reach it to everybody who deserves to have it. Many of them may not be able to afford it. So therefore, not only that it has to be manufactured in large number, but it also must be made affordable and if possible subsidized by the government for those who need such a walker. Rashtrapati Bhavan and the presidency 2012-2017 has made a significant difference to the polemics of the subject. It is the first time that we are finding the practice spawning the preaching. No matter what context arose, our president tried to practice everything, and secretary to the president practiced not only other things, but also innovation at the campus. Some of you may not know that she innovated a few devices for Ayush in the dispensary here, because she realized that the way they were dispensing those medicines and those treatments were not adequate, were not sophisticated enough, were not precise enough. And she worked with them and involved the scientists and engineers from IIT Delhi and NIT and other institutions to make sure that these became better. Now, this is just the beginning. Right from Sushrut time, these technologies, these tools had remained frozen in time. And now they are getting new energy to be revitalized and redesigned to become more useful to our society. Giving voice, visibility, and velocity to the ideas that grassroots innovators bring to this place is the responsibility of all of us, every part of the government, civil society, bureaucracy, politicians, and everybody else in the country. And I must say that the way media has covered the activities of all the innovators and the other creative people, artists and writers, makes me hopeful that this issue will not just end in the consciousness of our country with this conclusion of the valedictory function of the Scholar in Residence program. I think this issue will remain in our consciousness for a long time to come. I'm very hopeful that this partnership between the Office of the President, brought together by Mrs. Amita Paul and my colleagues in NIF and the Honeybee Network, will go a long way. Some of you might know that there is now a permanent exhibition at Rashtrapati Bhavan. Signatures of the serenity and the great amount of energy that Office of the President has brought to the innovation movement is not going to be erased, no matter how strong the storms are in times to come. These signatures will remain stable, durable, and forever will inspire us all to contribute to the growth and diffusion of the ideas of common people trying to solve persistent problems in an uncommon way. Let me at the end thank everybody else present here whom I may not have named, but who has contributed to this program, Innovation Scholar in Residence and Festival of Innovation, in a manner that very few things will be able to bring so much energy. I was very happy to notice that many of you, while you recalled your experience in this place, mentioned at least one common word, which was energy. The energy that you've absorbed, energy that you have shared with us, has charged us all. And we will be able to carry forward this movement in a manner that every creative person of our country feels cared for, feels recognized, respected, and rewarded. Thank you so much.
Professor Anil Gupta, Executive Chairperson, National Innovation Foundation, and his team from NIF. Artists, writers, and innovation scholars who are our esteemed guests. Officers from various organizations, various stakeholders' organizations, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. And here I must also recognize Shitanshu Maurya, who was our artist in residence in one of the earlier programs, who is here with us this afternoon, and Vinod Ghoshal, a writer who was with us in an earlier program. I'm happy to have this opportunity to address all the artists, writers, and innovation scholars who attended the in-residence program at Rashtrapati Bhavan from 4th to 18th March. As the President of India had said, and as was explained by Professor Gupta in great detail, you all are very special to us. You all are very special to us because you are creative minds, you are innovative, you represent the soul of the nation. The poets, the writers, the artists, the creative geniuses, they are the real ones who represent the soul of the civilization, the soul of the nation. So you are very special to us. We have benefited immensely from our interaction with you. There's so many new things that I have learned when I have sat and discussed with the group of innovators, the work they are doing. And it's opening up new vistas for action for us in Rashtrapati Bhavan. Friends, innovation and creativity are the agents of change and progress. Fertile human minds generate immense possibilities to do the same thing in a different but a better way, to mitigate hardships faced in performing routine functions, to introduce better quality of products and services, resulting in substantive material progress. From the abyss of mediocrity and backwardness to the zenith of advancement and progress. It is creativity and novelty that catalyzes many transformations. A society that nurtures creativity, promotes talent, and supports new ideas is likely to gain in terms of economic and social well-being. To move forward in words and actions is the mantra for the developing world societies. Making this mantra work would require us to not only recognize but propel greater efforts on the part of bright and talented individuals. As you would have noticed, that we try to practice what we say. We try to absorb what we learn in our interaction with creative minds. Every batch of innovators, writers, artists who has come here has left an imprint on us. We have picked up their technologies, we use those technologies, and we work with expert institutions to improve those technologies. We intend to do the same with this group here. I had a detailed interaction with a group yesterday, and we will find mentors who will take care of the logistics to take forward the effort that is being made. Nurturing innovative ideas can spur a movement of innovation in the country. With this perspective, President Mukherjee had directed us to initiate the programs that send out a strong message about the need to put innovation and creativity at the top of the national priorities. The in-residence program is a part of that effort. Due to the various initiatives, such as the 1 week Festival of Innovation, opening up of innovation clubs in almost 86 institutions of higher learning, innovation has now taken the shape of a movement in the country. Various stakeholders are now providing an impetus to this activity. Programs like Atal Innovation Mission of Niti Aayog and Manak of the Department of Science and Technology are some of the steps in that direction. The four critical pillars of a successful innovation value chain, as Professor Gupta always explains, are: sense the unmet needs, search outstanding traditional knowledge and innovative ideas, celebrate innovation to provide encouragement, and spread innovation through mentoring, validation, marketing, and other institutional support. In Rashtrapati Bhavan, we try to do all these four. The National Innovation Foundation is rendering a human service in these areas, and I want to really thank and compliment Professor Anil Gupta and his very energetic team for all the work done by them. I'm sure the innovation scholars would have benefited by their interaction with NIF and other stakeholders. I also thank the stakeholders who have spared their valuable time and expertise to help these bright innovators who are staying with us. Ladies and gentlemen, three batches of innovation scholars, writers, and artists in residence have earlier participated in the editions held in 2014, 15, and 16. Encouraged by the success of the program early on and gauging the potential of its reach, we in 2015 extended the program to include categories like scholars from IITs, NITs, ICERS, inspired teachers from central universities, SPAs, NIPERS, and IIITs, and award-winning school teachers from different states. We have benefited greatly from the stay of all these extraordinary minds in the Rashtrapati Bhavan. Once you become a scholar in residence, you are connected with Rashtrapati Bhavan for life. As you graduate, if I may be allowed to draw this analogy, from Rashtrapati Bhavan today, you become our alumni. You must maintain the organic link that we have established through this in-residence program. You will be our ambassadors, and wherever you are and whatever you do, please spread the message that the president has given, and that is, the destiny of our nation rests on the shoulders of the creative and innovative minds, unquote. Dear artists, writers, and innovators, there is a smartphone messaging platform, WhatsApp, which is in place to establish connection amongst all the in-residence scholars, past and present. I'm sure you will also be a part of this group and maintain close contact with everyone. Before I conclude, I want to thank all our partners, particularly the National Innovation Foundation, for helping us in conducting this in-residence program. With these words, I conclude. I wish all the scholars a bright future ahead. Keep making us and the nation proud with your achievements. Thank you.
Secretary to the President, Professor Anil Gupta, Vice Chairperson, NIF, dignitaries on the dais, participants in the in-resident program for innovators, writers, and artists, their family members, officers of Rashtrapati Bhavan, ladies and gentlemen, we come to the end of a 15-day journey together where we learned from each other, appreciated the value of creativity, and most importantly, made friends. The fourth in-residence program has proved to be an additional step towards realizing the vision of our Honorable President that focuses on encouragement to innovation and creativity as a solution to the problems of today. The program has been very meticulously designed and executed under the guidance of Secretary to the President. She took personal care in going into each and every details of the schedule, stay, and other arrangements to ensure that participants get to feel the comfort and inspiring environment within the President's state. I thank Secretary to the President for being a constant source of guidance, inspiration, and support for all of us. A special thanks to Professor Anil Gupta, who as Executive Head of National Innovation Foundation took a lot of effort in selecting and mentoring the innovators from various parts of the country. Our heartfelt thanks to the participant innovators, artists, and writers who exposed us to their creative world. Through their works, they have motivated many others who will carry forward the message of innovation and creativity. My sincere thanks to OSDRR Shakil Alam, who has worked very hard in making this program a success. I must thank the officers and staff from e-governance, CA2, administration, reception, CPWD, NIC, press, media, security, and household wings, who worked as a team, as always, to provide the best hospitality to our guests. Thank you all.
Yes, please. One more, please.